Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to thank Sankalp for giving this opportunity for showcasing our endeavor in this initiative. Well, just to add to what has been shown on the video, Fino started off in 2006 and has been a leading reckoning force in getting banking services to the bottom of the pyramid. So, just to add to what you have seen already in the video, today we have most of our product suites focusing towards banking services, insurance segment, and G2B payments. So that's what our product suite is all about. Fino is a technology and services company which is providing branchless banking to the underbanked and unbanked segment, with a focus of providing key low-cost delivery mechanism, because this is the physical infrastructure which is part of the entire platform. How we are doing this? We are doing this by a very secure, smart card-based, biometric-enabled platform. The card contains all the account information and can be operated with fingerprints. Very simple technology. We also provide this technology with our 15,000 Bandhu network, which is the agents who perform these transactions on handheld terminals. We believe that all financial services are required for this kind of segment, which not only includes a savings bank account, but also loans, remittances, insurance, and other products, which is forming the larger part of the portfolio today. Currently, we serve around 32 million customers, which and handle around 3.5 million transactions a month, and we are adding an astounding 67,000 customers every day. So that's what Fino is doing around. In fact, just to add, we also came across a very interesting figure a couple of days back, that approximately around 80 million BPL households in the country. You know, it's a very interesting fact that we are already reaching to 32 million customer base within that. So half the job is already done for us. We are gaming for reaching to the other half of the audience, and probably next year around, we'll be, you know, coming with that achievement. Thanks, ladies and gentlemen, for providing this opportunity.
Thank you, Satish. I'd now like to invite Mr. C.V.R. Rajendran, General Manager, Corporation Bank, for his pitch, please. Welcome.
Good afternoon, honorable members of the jury and distinguished guests. I feel it my privilege to stand before you to give a bird's-eye view of the achievements of Corporation Bank in utilizing technology as a tool of development. Corporation Bank started its journey from the temple town of Udupi in the state of Karnataka in the year 1906. Bank takes pride in its efforts to reach banking services to the unreached. All of you definitely have heard about the big financial inclusion initiative in our country. While some have taken it as a regulatory requirement, we at Corporation Bank feel it is our corporate social responsibility to underprivileged. A staggering 43% of our population is still deprived of basic banking facilities. Only 5% of the total 6 lakh villages have bank branches. There is a general feeling that it is a costly proposition, but we took it as a business opportunity, of course, along with the Fino. With the help of technology, we have developed business correspondent and business facilitator models, which provide service at the doorsteps of the unreached. Under this model, business correspondents act as an extended arm of the bank in remote villages. With the help of simple handheld machine, BC is enabled to facilitate small banking transactions at remote villages. The advantages of a branchless banking are: services provided at the doorsteps of the village, availability of basic banking services throughout the day. The BC is a permanent resident of the village and hails from the same village, and hence can assist customers at any time of the day. Hassle-free for the villagers, as there are no challans or vouchers, and familiarity in dealing with their own person. Reduces the cost of transaction, both for the customer and the bank, and it has the ability to handle large volume with less staff. It also reduces the pressure on the counters at rural branches. Services offered are like cash deposits, cash withdrawals, balance inquiry, mini statement, transfer of funds between own accounts, loan repayments, loan withdrawals in the running accounts, self-help group accounts, recurring deposits, milk payments, National Rural Employment Guarantee payouts, Social Security pension payments. Some of the additional products provided are person-to-person remittance facilities using mobile, and Janashree Bhima Yojana and Micro Insurance Premium Collection, remittances from one card to another card. Customer transactions are safe and secure. They are provided with the smart cards, and transactions are secured with card and the fingerprint identification. Transacting customer can listen to confirmation of transaction done in local language, and additionally, machine-generated receipt is also issued instantaneously. While the customer has the freedom of transaction as above, data is secure as it is stored only with the bank. As on March 2011, we have extended this facility in 2,500 villages, covering 14 states with 12.60 lakh savings bank account holders, which mobilized about 39 crores of deposits and extended general credit card loans for 23,323 beneficiaries amounting to 30 crores of rupees. We have the immense pleasure that we have been able to make a difference to this section with the help of technology. Our endeavor have brought us awards and accolades from well-intending institutions. We were the first bank in the country to reach 2012 March target 15 months ahead of the deadline. I assure you that we will not rest on these laurels, but strive to continue our passion. Your encouragement will enthuse and boost our energies to do so still better. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Rajendran. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the moment we've all been waiting for. Four startups, three jury members, and one great show, ET Now's Startup Super Angels. I'd like to invite on stage Mr. Sudhi Sayal. There you are, Sudhi. Stage is all yours.
So after that introduction, it's difficult to match up, but we'll try. So I'd like to invite Mahesh Murthy and Sasha Michandani onto stage, the super angels for this special format. A round of applause, guys.
Hello and welcome to the Technology for Development Startup Showdown, where at Sankalp, the signature event in India's social development calendar, and we have four of the most innovative technology for development companies here for this very, very special session. The rules are quite simple. These guys are going to be coming up here and making a pitch of their startup. They have 2 minutes each, and there's a buzzer to prevent them if they go any further. So 2 minutes is exactly what they'll get. Immediately after their 2 minutes, they're going to be quizzed and not mentored so much, but quizzed and heckled by these guys over here, Sasha and Mahesh. They also have these fantastic scorecards, which they're going to show as a score for each startup after they finish. It's very beauty pageant style, but I guess that's the way we like it. So there's a startup rebuttal followed by this. The winner of this special series gets a chance, gets a direct entry into starting up Super Angels series. So that's a big opportunity for them. I'm just going to play out the Super Angels promo so that you guys know what it's all about.
Influential investors come together to invest in India's most innovative startups. Are you India's next super entrepreneur? Starting Up presents Super Angels.
Super. That's awesome. That's outstanding.
And you think we have an easy job.
So one of the super angels is right here, Mahesh, also known as Quentin Tarantino. So before we waste any more time, I'm going to invite the first startup onto stage. Put your hands together for Forest Health. Music.
$50 billion. And the ironic factor is about 80% of this is avoidable or needless. There are many reasons. The most important thing is number of doctors. We hardly have 14,000 ophthalmologists in this country, and they use very expensive diagnostic equipment. So we are able to screen only 7 to 10% of the population, and people don't realize that they have a problem because they're illiterate. So our innovation is called Trinetra, which is a fully integrated pre-screening device. which actually can do an anterior posterior segment of the eye image as well as do refraction. It can be done by a minimally trained technician. It's non-invasive and does not require to dilate your eyes. It's got an auto algorithm which can actually detect 5 major eye problems, which constitute about 90% of the blindness. We already have about 30 validated customers, and we are gone in for batch production from our prototype. We're using contract manufacturing. We already have, we sell directly through our sales team, through distributors and through partners. We already have some of them. We had a very profitable first year, and we intend to grow to about 25, 60 and 70 crores in the next 3 years. We intend to touch about 20 million lives in the next 3 years. We're looking for funding for our capital for our next level R&D growth as well as for marketing. Thank you.
Fantastic. So the startups are going to be judged on 4 parameters. That's social impact, technology, business model, and market size. Let's get the ball rolling. Sasha, Mahesh, question. Sasha, what do you make of the pitch?
I think it was excellent, very simple, easy to understand. It was very simple business and tremendous social impact, clearly.
Okay. Okay. So ranks highly on the social impact calendar. What do you make of the market size given the healthcare space?
I think we've got the business model right. The market size is huge. So yeah.
We expect very pessimistically a global market of about 6,000 crores. And depending upon the adoption, we can actually, and if we're able to push the business model very aggressively, we can really have a fair pie of the whole thing.
You get the price points right.
Absolutely. That's something which we're working on very hard.
What are your price points right now?
Currently, if you want to buy the existing 3 or 4 equipments, we'll be 1/6 of the price currently.
Okay.
We are in the 4 to 5 lakh range.
Okay. What have you done in your technology to make this that much cheaper?
Basically, first, it's the understanding, the insight, which led to us to integrate all the 3 into 1. And the paradigm shift of actually moving screening away from hospital. Because today, everything is made towards a hospital for a diagnostic purpose. And all of them require a doctor on the other side. So what we have done is put intelligence to it and also made a compact design, which helps us to do screening for 3 major parameters and 5 major problems.
Mahesh, impressed by the pitch?
Yeah, so I have some benefit of having seen this pitch before. I do not question the technology. I question the business model and social impact. And that's because your product costs 5 lakhs per unit, right? That's just a product. You need a laptop by its side, which is another 50,000 to run it. You need a guy who's trained, maybe 50,000, 1 lakh. So it's 6.5 lakh installation, right? You're replacing something that's 10, 15 lakhs. I understand. You say you're going to be 25 crores in a couple of years. I mean, at 25 crores, that means you've sold exactly 500 products. I don't know how you're going to reach, 20 million people out of 500 products. So I think somewhere the numbers are probably not adding up to me. My sense is really one of, going with what Sasha said, which is, I would love to be able to see this at a lakh or so kind of price point, because the cost of goods in that device is not 5 lakhs. I think you're making way too much profit right now. I think if you figure out a way to cut it down, push the device through at a lower volume, you will really make the kind of social impact you want.